Hello? I don't have to do anything, right? That sounds good. Are we good?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
All right.
Be on, yeah.
Okay, be on?
Mm-hmm.
All right, everyone. Thanks for coming in today for this guest lecture by my good friend Gerald, Friedland. Gerald is a scientist in Lawrence, Livermore, and teaches at Berkeley. He's very well known for his book on speech and audio processing and more generic aspects of machine learning. But for the past year or a couple of years, he's been working with Michael Krell on trying to interpret neural networks. And he has, what I understand, are very fascinating insights into
right.
how to actually interpret what amazing machines are and how we can actually quantify them and what generalizations we can make. So I'd like to hand over to Gerald. This is an interactive seminar, so feel free to
yes.
This is a part of it. Yeah. Feel free to ask questions, interrupt if you don't understand anything, because as you all know, this is also going to be part of the quiz.
Oops. That's an escalation I didn't have yet. So anyway, yeah, thank you very much for coming. Thanks so much for having me. I did a bunch more just about myself a little bit. I did a bunch of more practical work in the past. So this was a part of my PhD, my God, 12 years ago, was writing a sort of interactive image segmenter. And I'm very proud of the fact because back then they put it into GIMP and it's still in there. And if you buy a book about how to use the open source tool GIMP, it's kind of a natural tool now. And I'm like, that's cool because I'm proud of this because it's actually AI that is used by many, many users. I mean, the GIMP is a Photoshop clone, open source, used by many users. A bunch of other stuff we did was, for example, we took Flickr videos and said, hey, where is this Flickr video, right? And so we analyzed audio and then with speech and different audio signals, and video signals together to basically come up with the geolocation of the videos are. And we managed, and I think that's still the ballpark, to put about 15% of random Flickr videos within 10 meter radius, which was way more than everybody expected at the time.